Hello friends, welcome back to the channel Vartheta Learning Platform. And today's video will be a smaller one because in today's video I am going to correct one mistake which we were facing in the last video while I was demonstrating you about the use of the gate host by name. So if you go to the playlist and you go to the socket programming in C++, then you can see that the latest video, the last video which was uploaded, was related to the gate host by name in socket programming. So this was the video. So in this video I was just demonstrating like how you can use the gate host by name, and in the end we have found that the bind function was returning -1, right? So at that time we were not sure, I was not sure basically that why it is not working. So something here it was coming like, yeah, here where I was putting it, it's a bit slow. So I was demonstrating you about this one, and when it came to bind function call, it's pathetically slow basically. So when it came to bind function call, that it returned -1. -1 means bind call is unsuccessful, right? So I have found the reason that why it was happening, and the reason is very simple, and I did one stupid thing there due to which it was not working. If you have observed, then I have used this socket call before the call to WSS startup, and that is why this bind call here, even after everything I provided correctly, it was not working. So let me just show you again that how it was going on. So as of now it's the wrong code, so you need to check that in this wrong code why it was not working. So I have called this socket call before any WSS startup. So here when I was just trying to call the bind function, then in that case when I go to the next statement, the I result was returning -1, which means bind call was failing, and the reason was that this socket call is before this WSS startup. I need to put this socket call, any socket API call, after the WSS startup. So let's put this after the WSS startup and let's see what happens. So here I'm just going to find out the socket using the socket call. Now it will work fine and bind will return 0, which means it is successful and fine, right? So let's put the breakpoint at the bind itself and let's run it and let's see if the bind function succeeds or not. So let's go to the next statement and you can see that I result is coming out to be 0, right? And that's it. And 0 value means that the socket API call was successful and we didn't get any error while executing this call. And if you see the same thing with the listen call, then also you will be able to see that after the listen call as well, it's returning me 0. Okay, so this was the stupid reason due to which our bind function was not working. Everything else has been demonstrated in the previous video, so I will keep the name of this video same as the previous one and in continuation of that video. So I will just make a copy of that video. I mean, the name of this video will be, the title of this video will be same as the previous video. I will just add the part 2 or part 1, and I will rename that as well with part 1, so that everything is fine and you are aware like these two are the videos which makes it complete about the gate host by name. Okay, so have a nice day. Bye-bye and take care.